This video is based on the paper key reinstallation attacks, forcing non-reuse in WPA2, and it demonstrates how weaknesses we discovered in WPA2 can be abused to attack Android and Linux devices. First, I will use an Android device to connect to our Wi-Fi test network without an adversary being present. Notice that this network uses WPA2 encryption as indicated by the lock symbol. Additionally, when visiting for example match.com, Android will use HTTPS as an extra layer of protection. This is indicated by the green HTTPS lock and also explicitly mentioned when viewing the web page info. In other words, all transmitted information is currently protected using both WPA2 and HTTPS. Let's now start the tools that Android will search for the test network. We'll try to remove the additional HTTPS protection of improperly configured websites. Finally, I'm going to use Wireshark to capture any data that the client will be transmitting. We are now ready to carry out the attack, so let's go to the smartphone and again connect to the WPA2 protected test network. Once the victim enabled Wi-Fi, Android will search for the test network. Once it has discovered the network, it will try to connect to the real test network, which is not what we want. Fortunately, we can solve this by sending special Wi-Fi frames that command Android into switching to a different channel. This tricks Android into connecting with the malicious clone of the network. Essentially, we now have a man in the middle position between the victim and the real Wi-Fi network. All his data is encrypted using WPA2 and therefore isn't readable by the attacker. As you can now see, there is HTTPS using the SSL strip tool. We'll continue to log in using the real. The attacker is now able to intercept the email address and password of the victim. Of course, this is just a demonstration using a fake account, meaning the login fails. Nevertheless, we can see that the attacker was indeed able to intercept the username and password that the victim used. WPA2, you must update all of your Wi-Fi devices.